Hi guys, welcome back to Topic Grammar class. I'm your Korean teacher, In Young. Today, I want to introduce another very special culture of Korea. So we have honorific way of speaking to the elders. And also, we have all different calling way, so so-called 호칭 in Korean language. So because we think age is important, because we should decide the 호칭, so we always ask one's age. So look at this picture. So we have 할아버지. So like she take a bow and say hello and 어르신. 자 어르신. So 어르신 is appellation that we call elders. 아 어르신. So we can say or call them directly, or just we can describe as a noun. So we have like 어르신. We have a lot of nouns and appellation, 호칭 today. So let's take a look more vocabulary. 자, 호칭 종류, a type of appellation. So we, as I already introduced, 어르신 is young youth to elders. Then elder call young people, 아 자네. So that actually means you. 너, 당신. But it's not appropriate to use 너, because even if they are older than us, they don't want to show disrespectful toward us, because they also want to be in good manner, right? So they usually don't say 너, right? So 너 should be between like friends, or when you are scolded. So 자네 is respectable way of calling you, but especially to the young people. But even if I'm older than someone, I'm not using 자네 because I'm still young, because I'm not aged yet. So 자네 is from like elder people's language. So 자네, 어르신. And then 양군. So let's say my name. So my name is 인영. So 인영. My full name is Park. Park Inyoung Shi, of course, is correct. But Shi is a general way of honor someone. Park Inyoung Shi, or sometimes we just want to be a good manner. But Yang is for female. So it's a little bit casual than Shi. So Inyoung Yang, or Gun is for male, so 철수, for example, 철수군 or 김철수군, like this. So again, I would not say 소연 양 or 철수군 to the younger people who are younger than me, because I'm not 할머니 할아버지 yet. So I would say 아 인형 I would say 소연 씨 철수 씨 right, but because she are the oldest, so 아 인형 양 소연 양 철수 군 something like this. So 자네 어르신 blah blah 양 blah blah 군. So 양 is for female, 군 is for males. Okay, we have another situation. So she has two kids. So one daughter, one son. 자, 딸, as you may know, means daughter. 아들, son. But pay attention to here. What is 내미? 내미. 아, 얘가, these kids, 이 아이가 제 딸내미예요. 아, 내 딸내미 or 아들내미. A cute way of calling daughter and a son. So 아들내미, 딸내미, we actually frequently use in our real life. My mom also called me like 딸내미, or my mom also called my brother 아들내미, or something like that. 자, but we cannot call the others' children 딸내미 아들내미 directly. So I would not say it's rude, but we actually usually don't do it. But it depends on. So what I suggest is 님, putting 님. 님, 님 is honorific word. So, 아, 선생님. Do you remember the 선생님's name? So we also can put 아들 or 딸 together. So 아들, 아드님, 딸, 따님. But change, something has changed because we deleted 리을. So it must be here. 리을, 리을, 아들님, 딸님. But it's difficult to pronounce. So we just omit 리을. So 아드님, 따님. In public, public area or public speaking, we prefer to use 아드님, 따님. And then only their own moms, own parents, own father can say 딸내미, 아들내미. Okay. Type number two, 선배, 후배, together, all together, 선후배. 자, 선배, this is like seniority. So when you enter the new school, or when you enter the company, or when you work in your workplace, there must be 선배s, right? Someone you started the work earlier than you. That's 선배. And then 후배 is opposite meaning. So 후배 is a newbie, newcomers. So 선배, 후배. And then that relationship we call 선후배 altogether. Similar, 고참, 신참. 고참, 신참 usually use, it doesn't matter if you use like in workplace, but usually in Korea, 고참, 신참 we use in military. 자, 남자들, the Korean men must serve their duty for their country. So 고참 신참, like in the military, 고참 신참, or very expert. Maybe they are very special community, not just like school or not just like company, not just workplace. Maybe they have their own community. And then they have clear special characteristic than 고참, 신참. But meaning are the similar. 형님, 아우. 자, 형님 means elder. 아우 means younger sibling. But it sometimes means not family. So they just say, they just call someone who older than you, 형님, 아우, 아우. Even if they are not actual siblings. 오빠, 언니 in the same sense. It can be real siblings or it cannot be real siblings. It does not always guarantee. So 오빠 literally meaning older brother, 언니 older sister. 형님 again 형님 and 누님. Yes, 형님 is for male, 누님 is for women. So, 님, 님, so more respectful. 친형, 친언니, 친동생. Now we have distinguished words. So, 친 means siblings. So, even if, for example, let's say I have a 오빠, real my sibling, 오빠. But I also say 친오빠, 오빠. I also say 친오빠 too. But when I call him directly, I wouldn't call him like 친오빠. It is quite unnatural. So 친오빠 is only we use for noun. We don't use when we call actually. So when we call them, we just use 오빠 언니. But 친언니 친오빠 is he's my real sibling. He's my real, I mean, not real, it's kind of like tricky, but he's my elder brother. 그는 제 친오빠예요. 그는 제 오빠예요. Or 그녀는 제 언니예요. 언니 있어요. 친언니 있어요. Something like that. So, but when we directly call them, we don't put 친. So, this is our first grammar point. 기는요. 자, 그렇기는요. 관계 없기는요. So, these usage are quite various. First, we disagree with one's opinion. So we refuse, we refutate. But it's not that serious, just like casual way of refutation. So, if you say so, okay, but I think, kind of this intonation. And then 비난하다, yeah, criticize sometimes, but it's not very serious. So number one is refusing, refutation, criticize, but not that serious. Number two, very different meaning. Sometimes it also, the keyword of being humble. 아니에요. 잘하지 않아요. 코리안, 한국어 되게 잘하시네요. Your Korean is really good, but you want to be humble. So, 아니에요. 잘하기는요. Something like that. But that time, we still disagree because we want to be humble, right? So, number one and number two, please remember. Let's take a more example. Look more example. 자, 관계 없다. There's no connection. 자, 관계 없기는요. 자, actually there is connection then, right? 관계가 있어요. 아, 관계 없기는요. 자, 강하다. Strong. 아, 강하기는요. 강하지 않아요. 강하기는요. A little bit disagreeing. 자, 동의하지 않아요. 자, 감기는요. 감기는 감기, so getting a cold. 자, 감기는요. 감기 아니에요. I'm okay. 감기 아니에요. 자, 가꾸기는요. 가꾸다. Make something beautiful. Decorate. 자, 가꾸다. 아, 가꾸기는요. 자, I'm actually not sure if I just see this part, this chunk. So let's take a look more example in a full sentence. 자, 제인 씨는 한국어를 잘하네요. 잘하시네요. 제인, your Korean is really good. 아, 잘하기는요. 아직 모르는 게 많아요. 자, 잘하기는요 is, of course, being humble. 아니에요. 아직. Still, there are a lot of things to learn. 자, 아직 모르는 게 많기 때문에 저는 잘하지 않아요. Being humble. 자, 음식이 맛있어요. The food is so good, so delicious. 요리 배웠어요? 요리 배우셨어요? Have you learned how to cook? 아이고, 배우기는요. Also be humble plus disagree. 안 배웠어요. 자, 배우기는요. 배우기는커녕. 자, 그냥 어머니가 하시는 거 보고 따라해봤어요. I just followed my mother's recipe. 자, 그냥 어머니가 하는 거 보고 따라했어요. 배운 적은 없어요. 자, 친형이세요? 자, 친. Do you remember the meaning of 친? So sibling, actual siblings, family. 자, 친형이세요? 되게 닮았어요. 많이 닮았어요. Look very resemble. 자, 당신이랑 그 사람이랑 너무 닮았어요. So I think you guys are siblings. 아이고, 닮기는요. 자, this one is not being humble. 가볍게 부정. Disagree, but casually. 아이고, 닮기는요. 저 그렇지 않아요. 그냥 아는 형님이에요. 그냥 아는 형님. We are friends. We are just friends. 그냥 형님이에요. But we are not siblings. 자, 모모기는요. 자, 대화할 때 축약하여. 자, 축약 means make it short. 자, 축약해서 긴요를 사용하기도 합니다. Okay. 자, 기는요. It's a little bit longer. Then you can make it shorter. 자, 한자를 많이 하시네요. Oh, you know lot of Chinese characters. 한자 많이 하시네요. What's your secret? 비결이 뭐예요? Please tell me. What is it? 아이고, 많이 알기는요. No. So be humble. 자, 많이 알긴요. See? As we learn, we should write 알기는요. Right? But if you feel it's too long, or if you want to make it shorter, you can use 긴요. So it's like 기 plus 니은. 알긴요. 그렇죠? 많이 알긴요. No, that's not true. 모르는 한자 아직 더 많아요. 모르는 한자가 더 많아요. Ah, there are still a lot of characters that I don't know. So be humble and little disagree. Because you want to be humble. So, 민수 형, 바쁜데 와줘서 고마워요. Thank you for coming. I know you are busy. 자, 민수, thank you for coming. I know you are busy. 아이고, 고맙기는. Don't say that. Don't say that. 고맙기는. 아우의 결혼식인데. 아우 means brother, but younger one. 자, 아우 결혼식인데. Wedding ceremony. 당연히 와야지. I should come. I must be here. 자, 따님이, see, 따님, honorific way of calling one's daughter. 자, 따님이 요리를 잘한다면서요? I heard that your daughter is really good at cooking. 자, 김치찌개를 좀 만드는 것 뿐인데요. 자, she wants to be humble because compliments on her daughter, so she wants to be humble. 잘하기는요? 아니에요. 아직 못해요. 잘하기는요? 그냥 김치찌개를 좀 만들 것 뿐이에요. 자, 제인 씨는 춤을 잘 추죠? 아, 제인, you are such a good dancer. 잘 추어요. 춤을 잘 추죠? 아니에요. 잘 추기는요. Be humble. 자, 리듬을 못 타서 춤은 별로 안 좋아해요. I don't like dancing that much because 리듬 잘 몰라요. 어떻게 리듬 타야 하는지 잘 몰라요. I'm not really good at getting into the rhythm. 자, 리듬 너무 어려워요. 자, 며칠째 계속 비가 와요. 비가 오는데 내일, tomorrow, 내일은 비가 갤까요? 날씨가 좋아질까요? This is not being humble, right? We are talking about the weather. So, 계기는요? I don't think so. So, casually refuse. casually refutate. 계기는요? 자, 개다. This person used 게다 form. 자, 계기는요? 나 I don't think so. 일기예보를 봤는데 폭우가 쏟아진다고 했어요. 자, 폭우 means heavy rain. I heard that there will be heavy rain. There will be a sudden rush of rain. 일기예보, weather forecast. 그렇게 들었어요. 계지 않아요. I don't think so. Okay, I'm moving on to the next grammar point. So first, 을 게 아니라, so now we should think about 으 and 리을's help. So it's also really irregular. So 기존의 행동보다 더 나은 행동을 제시해요. So first, there is a person and behavior. So this is behavior. But that behavior, that action is not the best one. But anyway, this person is doing. So I want to give a better suggestion, better selection. Why don't you do this? Not this. Why don't you do this? 자, 그럴 때, at that time, 이거를 할 게 아니라, B, 이거, E behavior, E action 별로예요. 이거 좋지 않아요. 이거 하지 마세요. 이거 좋아요. This is better. Okay, so, 얻을 게 아니라, get. 자, 얻다, to get. 얻을 게 아니라, 딴 거를 해보세요. 자, it must be other better suggestion. 자, 이동할 게 아니라, 그렇지 마, 그렇게 하지 말고 이동할 게 아니라, 자, 이을 게 아니라, 있다, make it connect. 이을 게 아니라, 줍다, to pick up, 주울 게 아니라. 자, 그런 다음, that is the usual way of this grammar point. But sometimes we also put request, 요청, favor, 부탁, can you do me a favor? 자, 부탁, 제안, suggestion. So let's take a look more example. 자, 여기 서서 얘기할 게 아니라 커피라도 마시러 갈까요? 그럽시다. Let's imagine a situation. After class, you met a friend. You guys haven't seen for a long time. 자주 보지 못했어요. It's very, 진짜 오랜만에 만났어요. 자, 그래서 you are very happy to meet her. You are very happy to meet your friend. So you guys were talking. 와, Because you couldn't think about, because you were too happy to meet her. 그냥 이렇게 stand up, just after in front of your classroom, you guys were talking continuously. So 다리가 너무 아픈 거예요. It hurts your legs. Sore. It's sore. 자 그러면 여기서 우리 여기서 이야기하지 맙시다. 여기서 이야기할 게 아니라, so this action was not the best one. 자 서서 얘기하는 거, talking and standing. 자 서서 얘기하지 말고 우리 커피 마시면서 천천히 얘기할까요? So this one is better suggestion. Let's go to the cafe. Why not? 왜 우리 커피 안 마시고 지금 계속 서서 이야기해요? 자 이건 별로 best way. This is not a best way. We have better selection. 우리 지금 커피 마실 수 있잖아요. 그쵸? 그럽시다. Like this. What about this? 자, 케이크를 드실 게 아니라 지금 식사를 하세요. 자, this person is having some cake. 자, 케이크 먹고 있어요. 그런데 케이크보다 지금 밥을, 지금 식사를 해야 돼요. Why don't you have proper meal, not just eating cake? 자, eating cake, we cannot say the worst selection, worst decision, but still we have better one, which is having proper meals. 자, 그러면 식사를 하세요. 그럴 게 아니라 케이크 드시지 말고요. 자, 밖에 나가서 산책도 좀 하세요. Go to walk. 좀 outside, be energetic. 자, 나가서 산책도 좀 해요. That is the better way than this one. 지금 너무 컴퓨터만 하고 있어요. You are keep playing computer. 자, 컴퓨터만 할 게 아니라 좀 밖에 나가서 산책도 하고 운동도 하고 좀 energetic, 자, 좀 활발하게 해보세요. Right? 좀 있으면 자야 해요. You should go to bed soon. 왜냐하면 it's late. 자, 지금 시간이 늦었기 때문에 좀 있으면 자야 돼요. 자, 우유를 마시는 게 어때요? We have a time keyword because it's too late. So we still have two different selections. Number one is drinking coffee. Number two is drinking, having some warm heated milk. Then. Of course, because of caffeine, it is not really good to drink some coffee right before you go to bed. Then, this one is the best, right? 자, 커피 마시지 말고요. 따뜻한 우유를 마시는 게 어때요? So, suggestion, better suggestion. 자, 커피를 마실 게 아니라 따뜻한 우유를 마시는 게 어때요? So, like this. 자, 서서 얘기하지 말고, 서서 얘기할 게 아니라 카페 가서 우리 같이 얘기해요. 케이크를 드시지 말고요. 케이크를 드실 게 아니에요. 지금 식사하셔야 돼요. 자, 컴퓨터만 할 게 아니라 진짜 컴퓨터 너무 계속 오래 했죠? 자, 그러니까 산책도 하세요. 자, all better suggestions. 아, 커피 마시지 말고. 자, 지금 자야 돼요. 그쵸? 자, 커피를 마실 게 아니라 우유를 마시는 게 어때요? So always number two is better suggestion, better selection, better decision than number one. So, 을 게 아니라, 만, 을 게 아니라, 자, we, verb, 을, 게 아니라, which is, we just learned, number one, and number two is noun, 만, or, and, we, 를. So, 케이크만 드실 게 아니라 식사를 하세요. So, same meaning. But we should put noun for, right before man. So, 케이크를 드실 게 아니라 we used 케이크를 드시다 verb first, but here 케이크만. No 드시다 here. So, 케이크만 and then 드시다 verb appears. 자, 케이크만 드실 게 아니라 식사를 하세요. So, a little bit changed, but the same meaning. So, be careful with the usage. And then, always remember the second one, the following one is better one. 자, 취직할 수 있을지 걱정이에요. I worry about getting a job. 아, 지금 너무 취직 어려워요. 취직할까요? 내가 지금 너무 걱정이에요. better suggestion. 자, 영어 회화 수업을 듣는 게 어때요? Why don't you take more English classes? 지금 걱정할 시간 없어요. 자, 걱정할 게 아니라 자, 그렇게 걱정하지 말고 수업을 들어봐요. 영어 수업을 더 듣는 게 어때요? 자, number one. 자, 계속 같은 음악을 들었더니 조금 지루해졌어요. 좀 지루해요. I feel bored. I got bored because I listened to the same song over and over. 지금 계속 똑같은 것만 들었어요. 자, 그러면 better suggestion. Oh, why not? Why don't you listen more, more different various types of genre of music? 왜 다양하게 듣지 않아요? Why don't you? 자, 더 better selection 있어요. 자, 계속 같은 음악을 들을 게 아니라 다양한 음악을 들어보세요. Okay? 자, number three, number two. 아무리 단어를 암기해도 잘 모르겠어요. I don't know. 내가 아무리, 자, emphasizing, even, 아무리 내가 지금 계속 단어 외우고 있어요. Even I keep memorizing the word vocabulary, I still don't know, I don't remember anything. 자, 무턱대고, 자, 무턱대고, without thoughtful. 자, 계속 그냥 roughly 공부하지 말고 단어 암기만 할 게 아니라 자, 상황을 잘 생각해서 활용해 보세요. So this person is not suggesting drill. Just repetition. 자, drill, practicing over and over. 자, 계속 이거 암기만 할 게 아니라 you should apply. 외운 거를 잘 활용해 보세요. 지금 drill, 이거 drill is not the only way. You should apply the words that you already know and then think about it. 자, 활용해서 생각해 보세요. Number three. 자, 어느 학과를 가야 할지 고민이에요. I haven't decided yet. I haven't decided which major I should go. 자, 모르겠어요, 지금. 그렇게 고민만 할 게 아니라 자, 고민. Keep thinking. Keep considering. 자, 고민만 할 게 아니라 부모님과 함께 상의해 보세요. Counsel. 자, 상의, counsel. Discuss. Why don't you discuss with your parents? 왜 그거 상의 한번 해보지 않아요? 자, 상의 한번 해보세요. 고민만 할 게 아니라 better suggestion. 상의도 한번 해보세요. Okay. 자, verb 느니 차라리. Verb 느니 차라리. So, 대비되는 두 가지 사실. We have two facts. We have two facts. Number one, number two. These are all facts. But we don't like neither. 다 싫어요. 다, I don't like them all. 자, 다 마음에 들지 않아요. 그런데 선행절의 행위보다 후행절의 행위가 더 나아요. But still, there's better and worse. Even if I don't like neither, still there is better and worse for me. 자, 그러면 이게 더 better예요. 자, number two is better. Action number two is better. Even if I didn't like both. So, for example, 자, 찾느니 차라리. So, number one verb is 찾다, to look for. But actually, we need number two. 찾느니 차라리. So, we need object that we can compare. 밀다, 자, 밀다, to push, 자, 밀다. But we should change it to 느니, see, 미느니. Then we should delete the final consonant, 밀, 리을. 밀느니, that does not make sense. So 미느니 차라리, that's the number one. And then actually we need another action as number two. 이렇게 얘기하면서 걸어가느니 차라리 셔틀버스를 타고 가자. 좋아요. 자, number one action. 자, 걸어가느니. 자, we are talking while we are walking. 자, 걸어가느니 차라리, this is better. Which one? 셔틀버스 타는 거. Take a shuttle bus.
셔틀버스 타는 게 그나마 좀 더 나아요. 좋아요.
Maybe this person didn't like bus.
걷고 싶지도 않고 셔틀버스 타고 싶지도 않아요.
But still, shuttlebus is better.
자, 그녀를 다시 만나느니 차라리 소개팅을 하겠어요. 자, 그녀를 만나다, 다시 만나다.
Seeing someone again.
자, 그녀, maybe they broke up. 자, 그 다시 만나고 만나다.
First, meet again.
다시 만나다, number one.
Number two, blind date, 소개팅. This person may be, I guess, this person doesn't like to meet her again. Neither,
소개팅,
he doesn't also like 소개팅, blind date too.
자, 그런데 we should compare. He should compare. So, 아, 그녀를 다시 만나느니 차라리 난 소개팅을 하겠어. 소개팅을 하겠어요.
So, 소개팅 is slightly better. 소개팅 is better than number one, meeting again.
자, 지저분한 의자에 앉느니, 자, 어디에 앉아요?
Sit a dirty chair.
자, 더러운 지저분한 의자에 앉다, number one.
Sit on a dirty chair.
자, 더러운 의자, 지저분 의자에 앉아요.
That's our this selection number one.
자, 서 있다.
Number two, just stand. Be stand. Neither I like.
다 싫어요. But 그냥 서 있을게요.
This is better.
Okay? 자, 지저분한 의자에 앉고 싶지 않으니까 차라리 앉느니 차라리 그냥 서 있을게요. 신참에게 물어보느니, 자, 신참, newbie, newcomer. 자, 물어보느니, 아, 걔한테 물어보느니, 차라리, emphasizing. 고참 선배에게 야단 맞고 말겠어요. 자, 야단 맞다, be scolded. 혼나요. 자, 그러면 내가 신참에게 물어본다.
I can do number one.
신참에게 물어봐요, ask.
And then number two, 고참에게 혼나요.
고참이 아마 저를 혼낼 거예요.
She will scold me.
나 아마 혼날 거예요. 그렇지만 number two is better. Because 신참한테 물어보는 게 더 나쁜 선택이에요.
Ask to newbie will be the worst selection, worst decision based on this sentence.
Okay, so number one, number two, and then we are comparing. But even if we don't like both, we should always choose one.
But if you think this one is a better choice, you should place the word to number two, right? But always number two is better one.
자, 문자를 보내다, 샤워를 하다. 거짓말을 하다, 아이를 돌보다.
We have all different verbs. So text message, so send a text, and then 샤워를 하다, take a shower,
거짓말을 하다, tell a lie, 아이를 돌보다,
take care of children.
일하는 게 낫다.
자, 낫다 means better.
자, working is better. 자, 일하는 게 낫다. 목욕탕을 가다. 자, public bath. 자, 목욕탕 is public. Everyone go and take a bath. 자, 목욕탕에 가요. 목욕탕을 가다. 자, video call, 영상통화를 하다. 아무 말 하지 않다.
No word. Don't say anything.
So, first, 문자를 보내느니. 자,
we have two selections. 문자를 보내다, texting message, and then video calling. But, which one is better? The speaker think.
영상통화, 문자를 보내느니 차라리 영상통화를 하겠어요.
For some reason, this person prefer to do video calling than texting message.
샤워를 하느니 차라리 목욕탕을 가겠어요. So this person is preferred to go to public baths than taking a shower. 거짓말을 하느니 아, 차라리 아무 말도 하지 않겠어요. So number one action will be telling a lie. Number two is saying nothing. So this person chose to say nothing. 아무 말도 하지 않는 게 말하지 않겠어요. 아이를 돌보느니 아이를 돌보느니 또 taking care of children or babysitting. 차라리 일하는 게 낫겠어요. Working is better. 자, this person think working is better than babysitting. 제인 씨, 이분이 지난번에 말한 김승호 선배예요. 어, 제인, look at him, look at him. This is 승호 선배. That I told you last time. 자, 지난번에 말했죠? I already introduced. 아, 안녕하세요. Hi. 아, 저는 제인이라고 합니다. I'm Jane. 잘 부탁드려요. 어머, nice to meet you. 잘 부탁드려요. 아, 저야말로 잘 부탁드립니다. 아, 저야말로. 같이 지금 respectful. They are all respect each other. 아, 저야말로 잘 부탁드립니다. 그런데 제인 씨 한국어를 잘하네요. 아, Jane, your Korean is really good. First, grammar point. 아, 잘하기는요. Be humble. Do you remember that? 아, 잘하기는요. It's not true. 아직 모르는 게 많아요. There are more to learn. 아직 저 더 배워야 돼요. 아, 승호 형. So we are calling directly. So 승호 형. 자, 여기서 서서 얘기할 게 아니라 커피라도 마시러 갈까요? So better suggestion. 이게 아니라 이게 더 좋아요. 자, 서서 얘기하는 거. Talking while they are standing. That's number one. And then number two was coffee. Drink some coffee. So go to the cafe. 자, 서서 이야기하지 말고 서서 얘기할 게 아니라 우리 커피 마시러 갈까요? 그러자. Let's do it. That's a good idea. 아, 그런데 이렇게 걸어가면서 얘기하면서 걸어가느니. So walking while they are talking while they are walking. 자, 얘기하면서 걸어가느니 again better choice. 차라리 emphasizing 셔틀버스 타고 가자. 셔틀버스가 더 좋겠다. 커피숍이 좀 멀어요. 커피숍이 좀 머니까. Now we know the all region. 자, 커피숍 the cafe is kind of far. 좋아요. That's good. 자, 그런데 지영 씨. Right, 지영. I'm curious. 자, 궁금한 게 있어요. 방금 선배님을 승우 형이라고 불렀잖아요. Just now you called 선배님 as 승우 형. See, do you remember the 승우 형? The very casual way. Not that 선배님. She just calls 승호 형. But the problem is, what Jane was curious about was 지영. 지영 is actually female. So we learned that 형 is only happens between male and male, right? But the problem is 지영 is female. So Jane was curious about this. 형은 형이라는 appellation. 형은 남자 형제끼리 부를 때 쓰잖아요. 쓰는 말이잖아요. 아, 맞아요. 네, 맞아요. Yes, you are right. 그런데 but there is an exception. 여자 후배가 so 여자 후배 female 후배 junior female junior, 자, 여자 후배가 남자 선배를 자, 남자 선배 male senior. 자, male senior. 남자 선배를 형이라고 부르는 경우도 있어요. Sometimes female junior can call 남자 선배 male senior as 형. Even if 형 is appellation between male and male. 자, 학교 선후배 관계는 자, Seniority at school. 학교 선후배 관계는 이성 관계가 아니에요. It's not a relationship. Like loving relationship. 이거 boyfriend, girlfriend 아니에요. 동성 형제와 같다고 생각해서요. We think 학교 선후배. So seniority. We consider seniority at school as if like 형제, siblings. So I just call him 형. Okay, 아 그렇군요. 한국어는 정말 어려워요. 아, Jane said, Korean language is really difficult. Of course, all language has their own culture, custom, history. It's not just about language skills. So we should understand the countries, or the communities, culture, custom, history, right? So language, I think learning language is very difficult. Okay, that was the text. And then actually, 선생님, as I see, this one is like very old story. As I know, based on my experience and knowledge, I never seen the girl like Jiyoung who call 선배 as a 형. If you guys are very close to each other, I think we can just call them like 오빠, 언니, other than like 선배님. 뭐 선배님 gives some atmosphere. 선배님 actually stands more further relationship. Like we are respectful. We want to be in good manner. But that doesn't mean very casual relationship still. So if you are very close to someone who is older than you, who's 선배 of you, then you can call 언니 or 오빠, 누나, something like that. Not 형. Even if you are female, I think that's like quite old school. I heard that my parents' generation did this. But not anymore, I believe. But this is also part of Korean culture, so it's not always bad to know, right? So let's that was pretty much. So let's answer the question. The first, 이지영 씨는 왜 남자 선배를 오빠라고 부르지 않고 형이라고 불렀습니까? Okay, why did Jiyoung call 남자 선배 male senior as 오빠? 형, not 오빠. Okay, so we can find the answer here. Here. Because we consider seniority at school, 자, 선후배 관계가, we're not boyfriend, girlfriend, so I think we can casually call siblings, like 형, 동성 형제와 같다고 생각해서요. 동성이 same sex, 그 같은 남자, 여자, 동성. 자, number two. 자, 원래 형이라는 호칭은 어떤 경우에 사용합니까? So this question is asking about the original meaning of appellation 형. So 원래 형은 어딨죠? 답은 형은 남자 형제끼리 부를 때 쓰는 말 아니에요? So this is what Jane already learned, what Jane already knew. So yes, that's also true. 자, 형, 남자, 형제, brothers. 끼리, brothers will call 형. 자, 그래서 답은 number one here, number two here. Let's review. So today we took a look about appellation or the way of calling someone. So first, I explained about 자네, 어르신. So 자네 is honorific way of calling you from elder people. So 할아버지, 할머니 will call you 자네. Even if I also have like 동생s, but I don't call them 자네 because I'm still young. So 자네. And then we also show our respectness to elders. So 어르신. So you can directly call them 어르신. Also you can use this word as a noun, 어르신. Okay, then in the same sense. 자, 양군. 자, 소연양, 지영양, 철수군, 민호군. So 양 for female, 군 for male. So 양군. Oh, okay. Then I want to explain more. 자, 어르신, 할아버지, 할머니, so called 할아버지, 할머니 may call you blah blah 양, blah blah 군. However, 어르신 is eldest, for example. 자, 어르신 is eldest. And then we are here. We are here. Us. We are here. 어르신 is the eldest. We are youngest. But in between, we have our parents. Parents' generation, right? Our parents' generation. Then, do they call our parents' generation 양군? No. 어르신 call us 소연양, 민호군, something like that. They don't call our parents' generation as 양군. It can happen, but not that common. And additionally, parents' generation can also call us 양군, but not in between this group and this group. So you can, of course, it's not 100% correct. It depends on, it really depends on situation, but usually we are the one who be called 양군. And also we learn about 딸내미, 아들내미. So 딸, we already know, 아들 as son, but 내미, this one. The cute way of calling your daughter, one's daughter, your daughter and your son, your own daughter, your own child. But on the other hand, if we want to call the other person's children, then we should put 님, 따님, 아드님, something like that. Okay, so 고참, 신참, also like senior, junior. Someone who is already know about that area. 신참 is newbie, newcomer. 자, 형님 아오. 자, actually they can be real siblings or that doesn't mean they are siblings. So this also very depends on relationship. So 형님, elders, 아오, 동생. Okay, number two, the type number two. 자, 선배, 후배, 선후배. 자, 선배, usually senior at school, senior at your working place. 후배, junior at school, junior at your working place. So that relationship is 선후배, all together, 선후배. And 오빠, 언니, 오빠, elder brother, 언니, elder sister, 형. 오빠 언니 is the caller, the person who call is female. 형 누나 is male. So female use 오빠 언니 to the elders. Males use 형 누나 to the elders. 자, 친형, 친언니, 친동생. 자, 친 means siblings. They are actually your families. So 친형, 친언니, 친동생. Wow, there are a lot, right? We have more appellation, but this is, if you remember this, that's very good to know, even if we have more. So, and these are our grammar points. Number one, 기는요. So the usage of 기는요, first, be humble. 아, 잘하기는요. 아, 한국어 아직 잘 못해요. 잘하기는요. Number two. Do you remember that the weather thing? So, it keep raining. It is raining. But I heard that I hope tomorrow will be fine day. 내일 좋았으면 좋겠어요. 그런데 아니에요. I heard that tomorrow will be 더 폭우가 올 거예요. Heavy rain. 더 올 거예요. 개기는요. 날씨가 개다. So, disagree. 아니에요. 개지 않아요. 개기는요. So number two is disagree. Number one is be humble. 자, 을 게 아니라, 아, 그럴 게 아니라. So number one action is already happening. Already progress, in progress. But we have better suggestion. 서서 이야기할 게 아니라 커피숍에 가서 이야기해요. This one, 뭐뭐는 차라리. Already exist the two actions, but number two is always best one. So, for example, 케이크만 먹을 게 아니라 케이크만 먹느니 차라리 밥을 먹겠어요. So, this one, you feel these two both don't like it, but still, number two is better. 그녀를 다시 만나느니, 아, meeting her again, meeting him again, blind date will be better. So, 아, 그를 다시 만나느니 차라리 소개팅을 하겠어요. So these two are quite similar, but always number two is better one. And 기는요, tricky one is has really a different meaning because number one is being humble and number two is disagree. So you should distinguish the meanings while you're listening or while you're using it. Okay, this is for today. I hope you enjoyed today, and I will see you next time. Have a good one. Bye.